Brandon Herrick here with Next Level Innovation, and today we'll be going over version 2 of the 5¾ LED headlight adapter. Stay tuned.
So what's included with the kit is the keyring, the clamp ring, two side mounts, the adjustment piece, all the hardware, including a Loctite bottle, and also the adjustment wedge. We're first going to start with the keyring with the indicating dot facing up, and we're going to install the two side mounts and the adjustment piece using an M2 Allen wrench and the M3x5 screws. Make sure you apply Loctite to these. Next, we're going to add the side clamps onto the three positions using the M3 by 12 or 14 screws that are provided. And this is also the point where we would add these EDPM 1/32 rubber spacers to the side clamps. And what we would do is we'd add them to the front two and we'd put them on the right half like that. And you want the circular part to be facing inward. Next, we'll take our LED headlight with it facing up. So you'll find the dot symbol at the top of the headlight. That is it facing up, and the key should be on the left hand side. We'll also take our key ring assembly, and you can see the key cut out right over there, and we'll match that up. And you want to make sure that this is sitting flush against the headlight, something like that. We're going to take the LED and the key ring setup, and we're going to add the clamp ring to the front of it, matching up the clamp ring tabs to the clamp slides. So it looks something like that. And we will take the clear washers and we'll slide them between the clamp slide and the clamp ring. And this is easily done when holding the assembly to the side. We want to make sure that the holes match up so that you can get the screw through, and skinny objects, something like this, or even pliers can help to get you that, to get the washer in place. We'll take the M2 Allen wrench and we'll tighten this up. These screws don't need Loctite since they're going into a nylock nut. And we'll leave this on the looser side, and we'll do that to the other two positions. With all the screws and washers in place, you want to make sure that you put pressure between the clamp ring and the key ring when you do your final tighten on all three sides. And you want to tighten the screw just so that the screw shows on the back side of the clamp slide. Make sure that all sides are equal when tightening. All right, next we're going to take the assembled LED headlight and we're going to put it on the bezel. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the bezel and we're going to slide it over the top. And you just want to make sure that the adjustment piece on the assembly is matched up with the adjustment piece on the bezel. So we'll just put the side mounts through. Just make sure that you check and see that they're not catching on anything. Line the holes. All right, now we're going to use our stock hardware with the T-nut facing out. If you happen to have a headlight that has the cable right next to where the side mounts are, what you can do is you can place the T-nut facing inward, and then you can buy an M8 washer at any hardware store, and you can place the washer right in between the rubber and the screw. Oh, right over here. Using our stock hardware, the screw, the spring, and the nylon nut, we're going to take the supplied lock wedge and we're going to make sure that the chamfer side is facing up, and we're going to just make sure the rounded side of the lock nut is facing up, and you're going to slide those in there just like that. And then to get the spring in between the two mounting positions, we're just going to start the screw off through the hole. And then we're going to add this spring. And what you're going to do is you're just going to kind of finesse the screw all the way up. And this will help you so that the spring doesn't come flying off at you. Put the assembly up. And what you want to do is you want to match up the spring with the hole on the adjustment piece. And you want to push it through just so it's on the other side, but not actually going through. Right now I'm using a Phillips head screwdriver. So right about there. And then we're going to add our lock wedge and our nylon nut. And you're going to put the actual back piece of the wedge in this hem right here. You want to just make sure that the holes are matched up as much as possible, and then you can start screwing until it catches. So, see how it's already catching? And what we're going to do is we're going to tighten that up all the way until the actual headlight is level with the bezel. And then we'll do adjustment later on. Here's what the fully installed headlight should look like. And this air gap is for airflow for the LED headlight. They produce a lot of heat, and hence the large heat sink in the back. Let's install this the same way we took it off. Make sure you plug in the H4 plug. So typically, what you want for an adjusted light, you want it either to be dead flat, looking up flat, or about half a degree angled down at the road. This avoids any light contact for oncoming traffic. And how you can do this is you can place your bike about 10 feet back from a blank wall, and you want to measure the height from the ground to the center of the headlight, and then you want to put that mark on the wall as well. And from 10 feet back, while you're sitting on the bike, that light should be spanning across that line equally. If you're 20 feet back, you want about an inch lower than that line. And that'll get you through inspection and all that. And then after that, you can do whatever you like best.
Thanks for watching, guys.